Today on Studio One, the countdown is on for college graduates. We'll show you how the job market looks and tell you which part of the country offers the strongest potential. Also, people are finding a variety of ways to go green. When it comes to energy, we'll show you how companies and cities are changing. And video games have become part of kids' normal recreation. We'll show you how one game is sparking interest in music.
Celebrating 20 years from the University of North Dakota in Grand Forks, this is Studio One.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Studio One. I'm Monty Cashel.
And I'm Kelly Corbo.
Well, we have a special guest coming on the show today to talk about a topic that not a lot of civilians know about, but certainly have heard of, chemical warfare.
Ooh, that just sounds kind of scary.
It is scary, and especially in times of war, it's something that our military have to prepare for, and he's the person that actually trains other personnel on how to deal with that. So we'll talk to him all about the dangers and what could happen. Also on the show, many Americans are keeping an eye on the economy and the job market. Soon-to-be college graduates are watching as well. We'll tell you which part of the country has the strongest job market for graduates.
Also, unexpected pregnancy can rearrange a person's life plan. We'll talk to someone who works at a place where young pregnant women can go to get answers to their questions.
But first, here's today's news with Shannon Dahl.
Thanks, Monty and Kelly. A woman in the middle of a right-to-die debate in France was found dead on Wednesday. This was 2 days after a court rejected her request for assisted suicide. Chantal Sabir was diagnosed with a rare terminal form of cancer 8 years ago. The cancer was located in Sabir's navel cavity, which seriously disfigured her face and caused her eyes and nose to bulge. The woman said drugs did nothing to help the terrible pain and wanted doctors to help her commit suicide. Assisted suicide is illegal in France. The cause of Sabir's death is not known yet. An investigation into the cause of death is expected. A woman tanning on a boat in Florida died Thursday after a stingray jumped onto the boat and struck her. The 55-year-old woman was on the boat with her husband and children in the Florida Keys. It is not clear yet if the woman died from the rays barb piercing her or the fall she took when the animal hit her. The stingray weighed about 75 pounds. Stingrays have been known to leap into the air when they are being pursued in the water. Scratching posts, citrus spray, and canned air all provide ways to prevent cats from destroying furniture, but they're not always effective. Surgically declawing cats has been an ethical dilemma for many years. Animal rights activists argue that cats are permanently disfigured and suffer high rates of depression after the change. Another method of using lasers to declaw felines simplifies the surgery and is supposed to minimize recovery time for pain. Some people feel the procedure is necessary for a cat to continue living in their home.
I didn't want her tearing up stuff, first of all, and second of all, it's really easy for indoor cats to get caught up on furniture, sheets, you name it, anything.
Experts say about 1 out of 4 indoor cats are declawed. Bill Gates can no longer claim the title of world's richest man. Forbes came out with its annual billionaire list this month. Gates is worth $58 billion. He was bumped back to the third spot on the list. Gates' good friend Warren Buffett took this top spot this year with a net worth of $62 billion. People speculate that Buffett's reign won't last very long, though, because he gives much of his money to charity. Buffett likes to use his money to issue challenges. Last year, he promised to give $1 million to charity if the 400 richest people in America admitted they paid less in taxes relative to their income than their secretaries. With a lot of negative talk regarding the U.S. economy, experts say there is one market that has a more positive outlook.
For high school and college seniors, spring is the graduation season. For college students, it means that life in the real world isn't far off.
Now, when they're into a field of expertise, study, or skill, they're finding that it is competitive. There are good opportunities, obviously.
Although today's economy may appear to be on the decline, today's college students that are graduating may have little to worry about when they're entering the job market.
For the fifth year in a row, it's indications from our national association that employers are going to be hiring more this year than they did last year. So that's a positive.
With student job seeking already in full swing nationwide, there is one U.S. region that is looking a little better than others.
for college graduates, the Midwest right now seems to be the strongest, with employers' intents to hire and plans to add to their workforce and or keep at least stable.
Regardless of today's steady job market, students heading into their career fields might still have some uneasy feelings.
There is always a little worry there going into, when you go into the unknown and go through a transition period. For instance, I'll be transitioning from college, going into the real world market, and becoming a pilot. And of course, you know, I don't know where I'm going to end up.
All he knows now is that the chance for getting the job looks pretty good.
The demand for pilots is right now is so high. They don't have enough pilots to fly all these aircraft. We got airlines actually coming here, recruiting people out of school to hire them before they actually graduate.
The job market can be unpredictable, but for those who graduate this year, experts say the outlook is good. Reporting for Studio One, I'm Dylan Wollenhaus.
Experts say some of the areas people are being recruited for are engineering, computer sciences, and accounting. And that's the news for now. Monty and Kelly?
Thanks a lot, Shannon. Well, that's always good news if, you know, the
college graduate, you can get a job in those fields.
That's the plan, right?
Definitely.
Graduate and get a job.
Woo! All right. Well, let's go now to weather with Becky Leggett. Becky?
Thanks, Monty and Kelly. You know, I think those students out there are following the jobs, and I think those birds out there are following all the warm weather up north, so maybe up to our area finally. Those geese are headed north once again. Well, we're going to take a look at those average conditions for this week here in our region. 38 is your average high in Grand Forks, 43 in Bismarck, 44 in Minneapolis, and 57 down into Denver. Looking across the nation now, 54 is your average high out in Seattle, 53 in Salt Lake City, and 70 down into LA, and over to the Gulf Coast area, 69 in Dallas and 65 in Atlanta, and up not to New York City, 48 is your average high. Well, later on in the show, we're going to have a story for you about going green. So we want to talk about some energy efficient ways to help out your home here in Grand Forks. So we're looking at a typical home here in Grand Forks on a sunny day because the grass is still green right now. So this house is facing south. Now, the reason that we would like to have south-facing homes here in Grand Forks is because the sun, you know, it rises in the east and it sets in the west like a typical pattern, but we're further north, so the sun has a more southerly angle here in Grand Forks than it does like in Texas or down into Florida. So throughout the course of the day, if we have our windows facing south, we can absorb more of that sunshine in through those windows, warming up our house for a lot cheaper. Another thing we can worry about here in Grand Forks and start to save some energy is through the way that we position our house relative to the wind. Now here in Grand Forks, our predominant wind is out of the northwest here coming in, so we don't want to have any open windows or any open garage doors on that side of the house. It's also a good idea to have your driveway facing south, so in the springtime you can get that snow to run off faster and have a clearer driveway. Another thing to make sure is in the wintertime to try to seal off those windows, or you can even put skylights in your south-facing ceiling. So some other ways to save some tips here in Grand Forks with your homes. But this coming week, we're going to be warmer than average down into portions of western Texas on up to southern California. Cooler than average, though, up in Oregon and Washington, as well as over on the east coast, all the way down from the Carolinas up to Maine. And wetter than average, of course, on the west coast again, Oregon and Washington, as well as the east coast in the New England states. And drier than average in the central portion of the United States. Well, like I was saying, later on this show, we're going to have a story for you about going green. So we're talking about going green this week. So how much longer do those compact fluorescent light bulbs, those are the new light bulbs out there, kind of squiggly looking, how much longer do they last versus the typical light bulb? Monty and Kelly, I'm going to have that answer coming up later, so be prepared.
All right, thanks, Becky.
Do you have any idea?
I'm going to go big and go 20 times.
20 times as long?
Yes.
That'd be great, huh?
Wouldn't it?
Okay, well, we can only
hopefully
hope.
Hopefully I'm right.
We'll see later. Well, we've got some highlights to go to now, and Ashley Portra.
Thanks, Monty and Kelly. When the New Jersey Nets traded future Hall of Fame point guard Jason Kidd to the Dallas Mavericks, people expected them to fall in the standings and get a lottery pick. Going into the game against Atlanta, the Nets were one win out of the final spot. Now the Nets taking on the Hawks in Jersey with 2 seconds left. Joe Johnson throws up a shot three quarters the way down the court. He'll hit it. Second quarter, Atlanta up. Mike Bibby passes around Josh Boone's back to Al Horford, who's going to dunk it. Atlanta still leading in the third. Devin Harris gives the Hawks the fake and drive and puts it up for two. Fourth quarter, Nets leading. Bastian Nachbar takes the shot at the arc, and he's going to sink that three-pointer. Richard Jefferson and his Nets make a great comeback in the game and take Atlanta 125-117. Now from Jersey over to Toronto, where the Raptors take on the Heat. First quarter, Toronto leads. Jamario Moon grabs the rebound and puts the ball in its place right in the net. Later in the second, Toronto still leading. Moon passes to Anthony Parker at the arc. He's going to do a dance and get it right back for the alley-oop. Toronto easily shuts down the Miami Heat, down 96-54. Sports fans are now not only drawn to games for the action, but also for another favorite American pastime, eating. And many professional sports teams are designating sections as all you can eat. Some healthcare specialists have deemed this marketing technique unhealthy, calling it binge eating. However, several team representatives say it's the fans who are responsible for how much they eat. Many teams are using these seats to make sporting events more affordable for families.
The more you can incentivize people and provide as much value for a ticket as you can, the better chance you have of selling a ticket. We're trying to reach a whole new demographic and a whole new market.
Some college teams have followed the lead of professional teams. At least 13 Major League Baseball teams are offering all-you-can-eat seats for the 2008 season. It's now time for the Studio One sports trivia question. And we want to know, where can you find these soccer stadiums located in one city? And we've got cities located all across England there. And we'll have the correct answer coming up next. And that's the sports. Monty and Kelly.
Thanks, Ashley. The Macarena, the Sprinkler, and the Brady Bunch all have something in common. One man has decided to incorporate them into a comedy skit that brought him internet fame. We talked to him about his popular comedy.
Also, pregnancy centers help put expectant mothers in contact with people who can answer questions. We will talk to a woman who will tell us what some of those questions are and how to find the answers.
North Dakota has more than 109,000 proud alumni. Whether it's connecting you with classmates or planning your estate, we can do more than ever for you and your alma mater. UND Alumni Association and the UND Foundation. We're helping you help UND.
Coming home from a busy day at work, sitting at your favorite coffee shop, reading with your kids, and fulfilling your dreams. At the University of North Dakota, you can fit your education into your life. UND Continuing Education offers flexible options including online courses, degree programs, and professional certifications. Never stop learning with UND Continuing Education.
You're watching Studio One, your source for news, weather, sports, and entertainment.
The Department of Health and Human Services says teen mothers are less likely to finish high school and are more likely to live in poverty than other teens. Pregnancy centers are available all around the United States to help young mothers. Executive Director of the Pregnancy Center in Grand Forks, North Dakota, Gloria Patoka, is here to tell us what these centers offer. Thank you so much for coming on the show.
Well, thank you for having me.
Okay, so what is the Pregnancy Center?
Well, we offer, we've been in existence for 20 years, going on our 21st year, and we do free pregnancy tests, and all our services are free. We became a medical clinic in 2005, so we offer first trimester ultrasounds. We do pregnancy counseling, abortion counseling, adoption referrals, and just a lot of things that help out these young women when they're trying to make a decision about what they should do.
Okay, so how do you fund your project since all your services are free?
Basically, it's only because of the generosity of individuals or groups, organizations, businesses, churches, that we are able to do what we do.
Okay, so when a young woman comes in and needs your services, can you take us through the steps that she has to go through?
Well, when she first comes in, usually it's a phone call, but many times there can also be a gal that'll just walk in, and basically we do an intake to find out a little bit about her and about her situation, about a little bit about her health history, and then we do a pregnancy test. The nurses do a pregnancy test, come back, give her the results of the pregnancy test, talk to her about whatever she's dealing with. If she is thinking of having an abortion, just a number of things, and we talk to them very openly and very honestly about the effects of whether it be adoption, whether it be abortion, whether it be keeping, whether it be getting married and having baby, just sort of help see where she's at and walk her through in a very truthful and honest way about all of that.
Okay. How long have you been working at the center for?
Well, basically, I have been around since it was founded. And so I've been, like I said, we're going on our 21st year, and I haven't always served in the capacity of executive director until I think it was last June. And I'm doing that for a while, not probably a lot longer, I'm not quite sure, but we'll just see. And but okay. I've been with the center for a long time.
All right, so since you've been there for 20-some years, what's the biggest change from when you started to now?
Oh, one of the biggest changes, I think, is, sad to say, we are seeing a lot more young women and men become sexually active at an earlier age. And one in four American teenagers, girls, have an STD. And one of the nice things that we're seeing is that some of the guys are coming in now, too, with them. So we get a chance to talk with them and visit with them. They seem like some of them are taking a little more responsibility okay. with the situation. So that is that's a big plus, I think.
Yeah. So is there a story of a young mother that you've helped that kind of sticks out in your mind?
Yes, there is. We had a young gal come to us about 18 years ago, and she needed a place to stay. And so we had shepherding homes at the time, and that's where a family in the community will house one of our moms, you know, for the duration of her pregnancy. So she stayed with them, and she would counsel every week with a life training skills that we still have right now and walk them through. And she delivered her baby and kept him and decided to parent. And she just brought him in, I think it was last summer. And he was this great big guy. And so that was really neat to see, because he was I think he was about 17. Years old.
Okay, so what are some of the challenges that you've experienced working at the center?
I think one of the challenges for a nonprofit agency is always their budget, and so that can be a real obstacle to try and keep the center running, you know, on donations basically and the goodwill of just the people in the community. That is probably, for an executive director and for a board of directors, that's an obstacle that you have that you really need to work on, consistency. As far as working with the girls or programs or anything, that's just a blessing to get to see them and work with them, and even the guys, to be able to give them some good solid information that will helpfully transform their lives. And we're talking about truthful information, you know, and medical information that sometimes they're just not aware of, and if they don't have that, they can't make a good decision. They just can't.
That's so true.
Yeah.
Where would you like to see the future of the center go?
Well, I think we are moving in a way that expanding some of our services. One of the things that we want to do is we want to start at some point in time, not right away, but we want to do STD testing and counseling. And that's something that we're looking at, and because we're a medical clinic, we're able to do that. But and also the counseling. You know, it's one thing to bring a young woman in and she gets a pregnancy test and then she can even have an ultrasound, but if she doesn't have counseling throughout the duration of her pregnancy and then afterwards, her life sometimes will not change. So that's one of the things we're doing, and Helen Nelson and I have both been working on that, and Helen's going to be overseeing some of the program services to get that area up and running even more so than it is.
Well, that is so wonderful. Thank you so much for coming on the show and telling us more about it.
Well, thank you for having me.
Coming up, you don't have to speak the same language to play on the same field. We'll show you how many international students on a university campus are bridging cultural barriers through sport. Also, winter months can beautify forest parks. The task of keeping the trails clear for travelers can be a challenge. Later, we'll spend a day in the life of a park ranger.
Studio One closed captioning is underwritten in part by Options, your disability information source.
Earn your engineering degree from the University of North Dakota while you continue to work. Through online lectures and brief on-campus lab work, you can earn your bachelor's degree in chemical, civil, electrical, or mechanical engineering.
We have a very good program here, and I'm very pleased and excited to be part of it.
All online engineering degrees are ABET accredited. Contact UND today to engineer your career for tomorrow.
UND's Center for Innovation, serving the entrepreneur community with two tech incubators, providing creative space for creative people, access to capital and university talent, scientific wet lab, state-of-the-art meeting space, startup and technical assistance services, recognition and networking. UND's Center for Innovation, the entrepreneur place.
Working with the Office of Workforce Development is great because year after year they get to the point where they know us, they know our challenges, they know our opportunities. Strategic planning has been very important for us at the mill. It keeps us focused, it keeps us moving forward in the direction that we need to go.
Companies grow through strategic planning and successful workforce training. Discover the advantages through the Office of Workforce Development at the University of North Dakota.
There's a place where American Indian culture is celebrated, where helping others is a priority and encouragement is abundant. At American Indian Student Services, our goal is retention and graduation of American Indian students. The American Indian Center is a home away from home, where students can find state-of-the-art technology and a friendly face willing to help. Contact American Indian Student Services at 1-800-CALL-UND.
Internet sites like YouTube have given people a venue to post almost any kind of video. Some videos become viral in nature because of their unique content. Judson Lapley posted a video called The Evolution of Dance. It has been on YouTube for 2 years. He is still surprised at what he can do because of the publicity. Lapley is an inspirational comedian who combines words of wisdom along with dancing and humor. He has been able to reach a much larger audience with the help of the internet.
What I've been able to do as far as the different groups and the size of the audience has changed an awful lot. You know, I'm not naive, I'm not dumb, I have no problem pimping that out, if you want to say.
Lapley says he is working on The Evolution of Dance Part 2. He will be adding a new material to go with the most current popular music. Now it's time to take a look at the events happening in your area. State parks are where human civilization meets nature. Today, we spend a day in the life of someone who works to maintain this precious balance.
Everyone enjoys a peaceful walk through the park. In some areas, nature can be difficult to keep in its natural state. Park rangers like Steve Best have the duty of keeping the wild in order.
I don't think people understand the full range of duties that we do.
That full range of duties includes grooming miles of cross-country ski and walking trails through the park.
This is a walking trail here, yep. Yeah, the cross-country ski trails, they're in pretty good shape yet, so we're probably not gonna touch those.
Although he is an expert at maneuvering the golf cart-sized dozer, his job requires more skill.
As far as the work goes, there's hard work, there's hard physically demanding work, and there's also, inside work. It's mentally challenging. You're always working with different things.
Steve says the destructive animals in the park are almost always of the human kind.
And oftentimes, we'll have campers that want to come in and party. It's just not something that we really allow.
Despite the challenges, Steve's job is to ensure the park looks as if it has been untouched by human hands. People often take notice.
It's, getting those positive comments is always nice.
A good way to escape the pressures of everyday life is to take a walk through the park. Steve and his fellow park rangers preserve the natural sanctuaries so we can find peace and quiet from time to time. Reporting for Studio One, I'm Adam Rimza.
There are nearly 6,000 state parks in the U.S. These parks are visited by 735 million visitors each year. Coming up, see how the buzz of going easy on the environment is translating into a different type of energy for customers. That story plus news, weather, and sports in the next half hour of Studio One.
Get a degree from the University of North Dakota without leaving the Bismarck area. The UND Bismarck Center offers quality and convenient master's degree programs and courses that fit your lifestyle.
I was able to obtain a quality degree from the University of North Dakota and at the same time have the flexibility to continue my career here in the Bismarck area.
Call for a complete list of degrees in cooperation with and located on the Bismarck State College campus.
The School of Engineering and Mines at UND has a long history of preparing students for successful careers. Through small classes and faculty involvement, students have unique opportunities to gain hands-on experience. Here, students launch a weather balloon to test a remote imaging device destined for Earth orbit. Students can also become involved in wind energy and fuel cell projects, design, build, and race a Formula One car, or even develop a camera that will generate agricultural images from the International Space Station. Find out for yourself how you can get involved at UND School of Engineering and Mines.
Hi, I'm Lori Line, wishing the University of North Dakota happy birthday.
Hi, I'm Zach Parisi of the New Jersey Devils. I just wanted to wish UND a happy 125th birthday.
Hi, I'm Larry Hagman. Happy birthday, UND.
Happy 125th birthday, University of North Dakota. Congratulations from all of us with the Minnesota Twins.
Hi, we're the Oak Ridge Boys. Congratulations, University of North Dakota, for 125 years.
Wow.
For almost 120 years, graduate education has been a focus at the University of North Dakota, and the humanities has been the cornerstone of our liberal arts tradition since the first advanced degree was awarded in 1895. Today, the graduate school continues to build on the success of this tradition by offering exceptional opportunities in the humanities. Seize the opportunity for an advanced degree in the humanities. Contact the graduate school at UND today.
From the University of North Dakota in Grand Forks, this is Studio One.
Welcome back to Studio One.
Thanks for joining us today.
Well, I don't know, Monty, if you're familiar with the song Stand By Your Man.
Oh, of course.
Yeah. All right. Mm-hmm. Well, I don't know. We wanted to know if that song kind of applied to people in public mm-hmm. who have been kind of caught doing some things they shouldn't have been doing.
Kind of caught or caught red-handed?
Caught red-handed. Okay. And like the governor's case with the
New York,
mm-hmm. yes. And, the wives always stand by him.
Mm-hmm.
And just, we went out and wanted to hear your thoughts if Really, the women, the wives should stand by their man.
Okay, see if that's the good thing to do. All right, well, their answers are coming up. Also in the next 30 minutes on Studio One, fuel prices are causing many people to budget in a different way. We'll talk to people who have to fill up to get the job done and see how the rising costs affect them.
Also, mini video games have a bad reputation. In our Studio One Spotlight, we'll show you how one video gamer is learning how to appreciate music while he plays the game.
Oh, that's how you're doing.
And the term chemical warfare scares most people. Today we are going to be talking to a sergeant who protects and informs troops against such threats. But first, here's today's news with Shannon Dahl.
Thanks, Monty and Kelly. Problems with a new plane are keeping it on the ground. Boeing is redesigning its 787 Dreamliner, increasing the possibility of further delays. The delay is expected to be another 6 months. The device that holds the plane's wings in place is the problem. Boeing expects redesign work, and a review of the project could be released at the end of the month. Originally, the jet was supposed to be set for the skies in July of 2007. Iran celebrated its New Year. Kicking off the celebration is a night of fireworks. People jump fire to symbolize a fresh start. Shopping and songs being performed on the streets are also a large part of the celebration. The changing season is said to bring the hope of overcoming the country's difficulties. This year is bringing a new American president and the start of their own presidential race. This might bring changes for the people of Iran, but for now, it's a time of celebration. Some grocery stores around the country have had to discontinue online grocery shopping because of low sales. But Hugo's in Grand Forks, North Dakota, finds the option is working well, especially for their elderly customers. Employees say the older population is becoming more computer savvy. The store receives about 4 orders a day and has around 3,000 online customers. Workers say it's convenient for people who can't leave home or are too busy to shop at the store.
It'll help the elderly, for one thing, who can be trained how to use a computer if they've never used one. Or businesses, doctors, lawyers, people who have very odd hours that would make it very efficient for them to shop online.
Customers can also order their groceries online and pick them up later that day. Treasure hunters are digging for gold in southeastern Germany. It's not just any old gold, though. The treasure being searched may be 2 tons of gold that Nazis hid after realizing they would lose the war. Some also speculate that the area could be hiding parts of the Amber Room. This was a room the Nazis stole from a castle in Russia. Its interior is completely consisted of gold and amber. Hunters have resumed searching for the treasure after concerns of explosives or poisonous traps postponed the exploration in February. Fuel prices are continuing to rise, and the rising costs of living are taking their toll on some who rely on their road for their living.
Fuel costs are reaching new heights. Gas and diesel prices currently range from $3 to $4 a gallon.
While everyone feels the impact of higher gas prices, the higher cost of fuels are impacting some more than others.
It's impacting truckers like James Richardson. Richardson says for a lot of company truck drivers, the lack of pay raises to compensate for higher living costs are affecting them the most. But he says there are others in the trucking business that are affected even more.
I've got a buddy that's an owner-operator, and it's putting a crunch on him.
Owner-operators have an extra burden because, unlike company truck drivers, independent owners pay for fuel themselves. Independent truck driver Jerry Nelson says his rising costs don't stop at fuel.
Well, everything has, you know, automobiles, trucks, tires, you know, just crazy.
Nelson says things can be made easier by using well-maintained older equipment and not spending money on unneeded things.
We kind of live modestly, so there are places we don't go, you know, but we're doing all right.
For other independent truckers, the cost can be too much.
It's a dying breed, I'll tell you.
And for these truckers, quitting their business and joining a company is the likely option. But for Nelson, who has been in the business 43 years...
But we just try to lope along.
With photographer Idian Johansson, this is Nicholas Shane, reporting for Studio One.
Some independent truckers can get a fuel surcharge when they contract with other companies. They are paid a certain rate for every mile they drive. And that's the news for now. Monty and Kelly.
Thanks, Shannon. Well, one thing is, with the warmer temperatures we've been having, the roads haven't been as slippery for those truckers.
No, thankfully. And for just normal people like me, I slip all over the place sometimes.
Getting better.
Yes. Well, let's go to weather now with Becky Leggett. Becky?
Thanks, Monty and Kelly. You're right on about those roads out there. Those temperatures are starting to warm up as we get over 12 hours of sunshine now here in Grand Forks. So driving out those driveways, no more ice to worry about. The bad news is down in Arkansas and Missouri, they haven't been quite as lucky. We're looking here at someone's backyard in Arkansas here. The dog went out for an afternoon walk and was met by a raging river in his backyard. These folks were stuck at home and couldn't even leave because their driveway was eroded by this river that just kind of turned up in their backyard. Areas of Arkansas actually saw up to 8 inches of rain in a 24-hour period. So it wasn't a good situation out there. Caused lots of flash flood conditions out there. Really, really not good situations out there. So areas of Missouri and Arkansas were the main areas of concern here. A lot of rain fell all the way from portions of northwestern or northeastern Texas all the way up to the Ohio River Valley. So lots of rain down there back here in Grand Forks, so we're not worried about that quite as much. Instead, we've been celebrating the St. Patrick's Day holiday, a great holiday here in Grand Forks to go green. And there's some people that don't just want to be green on St. Patrick's Day, they want to be green all year long.
Green is all around us. Green plants, green signs, green lights. But green has become more than just a color. The Water and Light Department in East Grand Forks, Minnesota, makes a Green Choice program available for its citizens.
We offer a program for customers who voluntarily want to purchase energy from renewable energy sources.
For East Grand Forks customers, wind power comes from Wisconsin and hydropower from Manitoba. Although they may not directly be receiving this power, customers are still helping the environment.
They're choosing to have some renewable produced electricity put into the grid. Whether those specific electrons make it here or not is up to physics.
Another way to be environmentally friendly is to use energy saving products such as these light bulbs, and this will save you another type of green. So whether you are buying green, saving green, or just plain seeing green, remember,
we're really all in this together, electrically speaking.
Reporting for Studio One, this is Kelly Krumlich.
Going green may cost a little bit more money, but it'll make you rich in the long term, thinking about the impact that you had on saving the environment. Back to this week's question about going green. You just saw these light bulbs in that story right there. We're talking about those new compact fluorescent light bulbs. Which is your answer here? Those compact fluorescent light bulbs actually last 10 times longer than your typical light bulb, saving you anywhere between $30 and $36 in the long run.
That's a lot of money. Mm. Thanks, Becky. Not 20, but I'll take 10. 10 times is just as good.
That's great.
That is awesome.
Why not, right?
Seriously.
Okay. Well, let's go to sports again. Ashley Porcher has more there.
Thanks, Monty and Kelly. Soccer is popular in many countries around the world. Some college students are trying to spread soccer fever to their new American friends.
Being from a small country, these boys have big goals.
I'm from Oslo, Norway.
I'm from Oslo, Norway.
Norway, Norway.
Coming from a different background, nationalities, economic status, it's often hard to find a common language. For some, it is art. For others, it's learning the other language. But for these guys, it's soccer.
Well, I grew up in soccer. It's the only sport I've been playing since I was a kid, so kind of brought that with me from Norway.
Coming to a foreign place, it may be impossible to get to know people. With this team, they only have one goal in mind.
Well, I think it's a lot of fun to get to know people by playing soccer, and that's pretty much why I do it.
On a soccer team, some players put their skills to test. Other players bring leadership, while this soccer player, Anders Sertet, brings humor.
How's my hair?
Sertet might be his team's comic relief, but he couldn't be more serious about the importance of this sport.
Well, it explains itself. It's a brilliant sport, so.
Soccer is not the reason they're here, but it is a cultural bridge they can use. They've only experienced America for a few months, but so far, so good.
I really like it here. It's kind of cheap compared to Norwegian prices, so.
With photographer Nick Shane, I'm Casey Hayden reporting for Studio One Sports.
The soccer team has several other nationalities represented. Many are here on foreign exchange programs, and they say they are enjoying their time in North Dakota. Now the answer to this week's Studio One sports trivia question, and where can you find both of these soccer stadiums? The answer is A, Birmingham. And both stadiums can actually hold at least 30,000 spectators each. And that's the sports. Monty and Kelly.
Thanks, Ashley. Nerves can start kicking in when people have to go in front of big crowds. We'll take you to a place where people get a little help from their friends and fans.
Also, recently many video games have been coming out that require people to play with toy instruments. Some people say these games help with hand-eye coordination. We'll show you a kid that is reaping benefits from playing in an imaginary band.
Studio One closed captioning is underwritten in part by University of North Dakota student government.
What are you doing?
Earning my engineering degree online through UND.
Engineering online? You can't do that.
Well, I am.
Huh. Well, I bet UND doesn't offer nursing online.
It does.
What about social work?
That too.
The University of North Dakota offers unique online courses and degree programs. From bachelor to master's level, you can find more than 15 degrees online.
How about forensic psychology?
That too.
We know exactly what you're looking for.
Because we've already found it.
The Energy and Environmental Research Center in Grand Forks, North Dakota has opportunities available for you. You'll work with a dynamic team of professionals in a variety of programs that have gained international recognition. We offer competitive salaries, an outstanding benefits package, and a place for you to pursue your dreams. To learn more about opportunities at the EERC, visit us on the web.
The Workforce Development Office helped our organization identify specific health concerns faced by our employees. Along with that, they also helped us come up with a wellness program to address those concerns. They did a great job for us as we finalized our plans for the Alaris Wellness at Work program.
Call us to help your organization discover creative solutions to your workforce challenges. Workforce Development, a service of the Division of Continuing Education at the University of North Dakota.
You're watching Studio One from the University of North Dakota in Grand Forks.
Some musicians perform for fame and fortune, but at one event, artists are ready to share their talents with a crowd of any size.
In a way, open mic is a musical buffet, but artists visit this pizza shop to share more than just talent.
It's like a mutual respect thing. You listen to me and I'll listen to you, you know, because it's just a matter of getting out there and having somebody to entertain.
Musicians say this event can even cure a nervous stomach.
Because it is cool to have people clap for you after you play. It sort of takes away their jitters, I guess.
For over 30 years, artist Mark Serlin has enjoyed performing. His first challenge in learning how to play the guitar was convincing his parents to let him buy one. So he handcrafted a persuasive plan.
I made a guitar that looked like John Lennon's Gibson Custom SG, the one with the points, out of cardboard, put elastic strings on it, painted it and stuff, and I'd be playing to the Beatles. The past
is here. Today, Mark continues to perform despite some new challenges.
I have a problem with numb hands and circulation because if I squeeze a pick for like 10, 15 seconds, my fingers go numb.
So Mark made a guitar pick held to his hand with Velcro. And at the end of a hard day's night, the motivation is clear.
I'll play for one or play for 100. I like to entertain.
And if Mark had the choice, he'd play at open mic 8 days a week. For Studio One, I'm Suzanne Schmidt.
Mark hopes to sell his guitar pick invention. He says that it would be great for younger players because it would keep them from dropping the pick while playing. When a politician is caught having an affair, three things usually happen. A news conference is called, an apology is made, and the wife is often seen at her husband's side. Recently, the former governor of New York and his wife followed this formula. We wanted to know your thoughts on if wives should stand by their men when their most private matters go public.
I really couldn't say what
anyone should do in that situation.
Politics probably shouldn't play into it at all. It's deeper than that. It's more than that.
I think that everybody makes mistakes. They're human. So if they have worked things out, that it should be fine.
That's an issue they have to deal with themselves.
I don't think it should matter if it has anything to do with politics. I think that if someone cheats on you and it's your opinion, if you want to leave, then you should leave.
Just because they're in a political world doesn't mean she has to brunt the embarrassment of him.
I think they should look at the moral issue of the whole subject and maybe work things out.
Some people say it's for the kids' sake, but you know, what is that teaching the kids? You know, that it's okay for the husband to go do this.
Most video games are a stationary hobby. There is a recent game that puts its players on an imaginary stage. In our Studio One Spotlight segment, we show you how a particular type of video game is giving kids the incentive to do the real thing.
Kids staring at the TV playing video games for hours used to be a bad thing. There is a trend starting where video games take you from being couch potato to being in a rock band.
And many times they're jumping or they're just trying to mouth the words or just gritting their teeth or doing other things to just get more into the music, get more into doing it the right way.
There's a new game where you get to be a rock star. The game puts you on stage and gives you either a guitar, microphone, or drum set.
I've only lost once when I was an expert and the guy I was facing chose easy. So he got like tons more points than me, which is kind of cheap, but...
Gaming skills and hand-eye coordination are not the only benefits of this game. Tim's mom says the game is helping him in another area.
They at first said, no, Mom, it's really different. I mean, you know, it's not strings, it's color-coded, and we know exactly what to do. But then all of a sudden I'd hear them when they're playing. I'd hear them strumming out those songs.
Tim also plays the real guitar. His teacher says the video games can be positive.
I'm seeing great things, mainly repertoire. You ever hear this one, Rock You Like a Hurricane, you know? It's like, yeah, I heard that on Rock Band, you know? So I'm like, alrighty then.
As far as playing these songs on a controller guitar versus a regular guitar, it is like comparing the Rock Band Kiss to Britney Spears. They are completely different.
And I have to be there as a shoulder to cry on for as they start to decompress from the illusion of... Oh, this is how it really goes.
Well, first of all, you get to like control every note and how it sounds. But on Rock Band, you only get 5 notes. So just gotta pretend they're on higher frets.
Even with it being harder to play the real guitar, instructors are excited over the interest of music.
I'm finding that a lot of students adults, I mean, all across the board, are becoming more aware of the guitar.
Video games have been given a bad rep in the past. With these new types of video games getting the player out of the chair and up in the air, parents and teachers are starting to become more lenient on letting their child play. Rocking out for Studio One, I'm William Hart.
The NPD group says the video game Guitar Hero Legends of Rock became the number one selling game of all time in a single year. It generated more than $1 billion in revenue for its parent company, Activision. There are many training exercises that the U.S. military go through to prepare against attacks. We will be talking to an emergency management specialist who know all about reacting to chemical warfare.
Visit onlinecourses.und.edu today.
The College of Business and Public Administration at the University of North Dakota is proud to announce the Page Family Marketing Center. A gift from alumni Greg and Cindy Page, this center promises real-world experiences as students begin careers in marketing. The center includes a specially designed conference room for focus group research. An adjacent lab offers real-time access to software and data for marketing decisions. The Page Family Marketing Center, your next step in marketing.
There's a place where American Indian culture is celebrated, where helping others is a priority and encouragement is abundant. At American Indian Student Services, our goal is retention and graduation of American Indian students. The American Indian Center is a home away from home, where students can find state-of-the-art technology and a friendly face willing to help. Contact American Indian Student Services at 1-800-CALL-UND.
The University of North Dakota Graduate School offers unique opportunities for students who love to keep their eyes on the skies. Atmospheric science students are using advanced radar to see what's happening deep inside the clouds. Students and professors in our space studies program are helping to shape the future of interplanetary travel. Major projects include designing and testing a spacesuit for the mission to Mars. Reach for the skies and beyond with a graduate degree from the University of North Dakota.
Chemical weapons are destructive and can have terrible effects on the human body. There are different types of chemicals, and each and every one of them has different effects. The U.S. military has to be able to survive and operate under a chemical weapon threat. Staff Sergeant Matt Sutton is an emergency management specialist who studies and trains for such threats. Thanks for coming on the show today.
Thanks for having me.
What exactly do you do?
Well, it's kind of broad. I'm an emergency management specialist. It used to be called readiness. But exactly what I do is I deal with chemical threats that happen if they were to happen. So what we do is pretty much during peacetime is we deal with natural disasters. But during wartime, we deal with chemical, biological, and nuclear threats. And that's pretty much what we do.
Okay. So. And, you know, when you talk about chemicals, there are just, countless chemicals. As far as the dangerous ones that you deal with, how do you categorize them?
Well, there's three really important ones. It's choking agents, and then there's also blood agents, and then there's nerve agents, which are the ones we're most, dealing with. And they pose the greatest threat to an airbase. They're usually launched by TBMs, tactical ballistic missiles, and if they were to launch, they'd explode over the base and they'd kind of trickle down. It takes about an hour for them to fall down to the ground. Mm-hmm. And they really hinder operations. Dealing with like protective overgarments and stuff like that, you have to be prepared.
Okay. And that sounds scary. I mean, having a weapon go off with these chemicals falling down around you. You talked about gear to protect yourself. What kind of gear can protect you against chemicals?
Well, there's two types of gear. There's a BDO, which is a battle dress over garment, and there's a CPO. The CPO is kind of newer. It's got an integrated hood with it, as we're looking here. This is the old BDO from this graphic. So the newer ones, it's got an integrated hood, and they're really nice, and they can actually be washed up to 6 times. But the older ones, they're full of charcoal. So after you take them off, it's charcoal all over your uniform. Hmm. And the BDO is pretty much what we're using for training. And when troops are getting deployed now, they're getting deployed with the new CPO.
So, how do you train for something like this?
There's many different training exercises that we go through. Pretty much we'll get, like we're getting deployed somewhere, and we'll go somewhere. This is actually a picture in Alaska of us doing some training. Some people that got exposed, and everyone's kind of watching.
So the guys on the ground, they're playing dead, or are they?
Yeah, they're playing dead. They were exposed. They didn't get their mask on in time, and they've been exposed to nerve agents. So everyone kind of just sat around and didn't know what to do. So we just kind of said, "Hey, they've been exposed. You're gonna help your troops." So it's kind of a lot of training exercise. So it's pretty much we'll go someplace and they'll hit us with a chemical weapon, and at being emergency management, we have to go out and figure out what kind of chemical they hit us with.
How do you do that? How can you tell when there's a bad chemical in the air?
Well, when a base is, when you know, people are deployed, they set up things called LDPs, which are liquid detection points. And on these liquid detection points, there's M8 paper, which M8 paper detects what kind of chemical you're dealing with, whether it's, you know, blister agent, nerve agent, stuff like that. There's also such things as M9 tape, which goes on the outer of your overgarment, which tells you if you've been exposed. It turns a reddish color and tells you if you've been exposed. There's also M22s, which pick up vapor from certain nerve agents, such as sarin and such things like that.
Okay, so this is scary stuff.
It's scary.
Are you scared when you know a lot about this stuff? What do you feel about chemical warfare?
Well, see, a lot of people think that, you know, chemical warfare can never really happen, but in reality, I mean, it's very easy to make, and it can cause very great damage to air bases, especially. So yeah, you know, it's a little scared, but it's knowing that we have gear, we have masks, that stuff that we can go out in a contaminated environment and actually complete our mission. So I mean, just knowing that we have that kind of gear kind of helps us to be prepared and, you know, stay ahead of the game. So
how much of a threat do you think there is for chemical warfare to happen?
It varies. You know, it's such things, you know, like launching intercontinental ballistic missiles can happen. But, you know, it, for the U.S., not really a problem. But for such bases that are deployed over into Iraq and stuff like that, I mean, it can happen. So, mm-hmm. You know, you always just got to be prepared.
And what about the U.S.'s stance on using chemical weapons?
Well, it used to be that we'd use it in retaliation. But now we're getting rid of all of our stockpiles, and we will never use it, just because it's, you know, chemical warfare. It's very hard to control. Mm-hmm. So you know, just that's kind of the U.S. stance on it right
now. Well, thanks for coming on the show and telling us all about this. It's some scary stuff, but some great information.
Yeah. Thanks for having me.
Thanks. Well, you're watching Studio One from the University of North Dakota. We'll be back right after this.
Closed captioning for Studio One is underwritten in part by All True Health System, here for life.
It's not the size of the woman in the fight. It's the size of the fight in the woman.
Tune in next week on Studio One. We'll take you to a meal where etiquette is the main course. Plus, we'll have other news and entertainment stories for you.
We're going to leave you now with pictures of indoor soccer players. From all of us here at Studio One, have a great week.